1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Self-awareness is a superpower. My name is Kathy LaDonna. Welcome to Soul and Vibration. Jupiter in Capricorn or the 10th house. So this placement makes me smile because you are someone who basically other people might see you as successful, or it is your legacy to be seen as a successful philosopher or someone who is very knowledgeable when it comes to your area of studies. So it could be, you know, basically a philosopher of business or a philosopher of art or whatever it is. But basically you aspire, you have big ambitions. Your ambitions are larger than life. With Jupiter energy having to do with luck, opportunity, expansion, basically a lot of luck and opportunity will come through your father or father figure. It could be your father or your father's family. And if your mother is your father figure, maybe that's a possibility too. And again, luck does come to us sometimes just for the sake of it, but I believe this is the kind of luck, like Oprah said, luck is when hard work meets preparation. No, like Oprah said, luck is when preparation or hard work meets opportunity. So of course, whatever it is that you're pursuing in your life, say you want to be a businessman or a businesswoman, it's important for you to empower yourself and know as much as you can when it comes to this area, so that you can feel confident when you are speaking or helping people with this. Because if you're not confident, other people will sense that you're not confident. But basically, yes, if you have been preparing yourself in this area of your life, luck and opportunity will come in the sense that, say, for example, you create a small business idea. You create a small business idea and you share it. And basically it goes viral and you are able to ride the waves and become a billionaire after, because you were prepared. Where say, for example, you had this idea, you share it, but there was no preparation. So you weren't able to keep up with the demand. Because you weren't able to keep up with the demand, you seemed as if you were unlucky, when really you weren't unlucky. You just weren't able to keep up with the demand. And that's the other thing too, when we talk about luck coming from the father or the father's side, you know, basically it's like, yeah, you might gain material things from the father or the father's side, whether it's basically, you know, social status or, you know, material things, but it's like you won't experience the luck until you are actually working towards something, because this is the way how the universe is going to support you, by filtering through the luck in this area of your life having to do with the father energy. So, you know, if your mother fathered you or whatnot, basically the father energy, it could be your grandfather, whatever, through father energy is how luck and opportunity will come into your life. And a lot of the times, luck and opportunity doesn't necessarily have to be someone giving us this huge loan. Luck and opportunity could be, you know, you grew up in a very negative living situation, and maybe your grandfather was able to talk to you and help you to gain a different perspective. And from the perspective that your grandfather helped you to gain, basically it changed your inner conversation with yourself. It changed the way you saw yourself in the world. And through that, you have been able to be an extremely successful businessman or businesswoman, because you saw yourself being successful with this placement. You saw yourself climbing up out of the hole that you started out life in when it comes to this placement. With Jupiter having to do with luck, opportunity, expansion, and basically overall success. Success and opportunity will come to you if you are working in business. Something having to do with business is important. And working towards a legacy. When I say legacy, it's what will people know you for? But mainly it has to do with, you know, being in charge, being the CEO of something, someone who provides some kind of structure, someone who is basically responsible for others. And at the same time too, with this placement with Capricorn also representing the 10th house, you will be seen as someone who is lucky. So even if you don't see yourself as lucky, because maybe your definition of success is money, and basically, you know, the more you gain, the more it gets bigger, or your definition of success is material gain. So it's like a carrot constantly moving away from you. You it's insatiable. You can never be satisfied. You know, you might not see yourself as lucky, but everybody else sees you as lucky, because to them it might seem like things just comes to you. But of course, they don't know about the fears that you might experience, but push past those fears anyways, and be courageous and go towards the things that you are trying to make happen for yourself. Like, they can't see the risk that you take, or the sleepless nights where you're creating your business plans or working towards your dreams, your goals, or whatnot. They just see you as lucky. But you might not be able to see this for yourself, because it's like Jupiter being so expansive, it's like you can't get enough, you know. So be careful when it comes to that, because again, like, you know, in Jamaica we have this saying, crave and choke puppy, like being too greedy will choke you. So I'm not saying people with this placement is greedy, but be clear about what your definition of success is, so you can know when you have reached it and create another one for yourself. And I think it's important for us to all know that, or for us to define success for ourselves, having to do with spiritual and emotional growth. That is where we should basically rate our success on. Because if you are constantly growing spiritually and emotionally, regardless of whatever you lose, you can gain it back instantly. And with this placement, luck and opportunity and blessings, good fortune will always come to you as long as you are pursuing a business where you are in charge, where you are the head, you are the CEO, you are the face that everybody else sees. Like, the number 10 is at the very top of the astrological wheel. You are the face of the company, you are the face of the business, you are the face of the product. Luck and opportunity will come to you if you are constantly working towards that position in your life. With Jupiter being in Capricorn, and Capricorn also ruling the 10th house, people will see you as a philosopher. People will see you as a preacher. People will see you as maybe a spiritual healer, because because Jupiter energy also has to do with, you know, the spiritual mind, like basically taking anything to the highest level, and spirituality plays a huge part in that. So people may see you as that. So it doesn't have to necessarily be business that you are working on. It could be, you know, being a motivational teacher, speaker, preacher, you know, someone that basically uses their big picture thinking and their optimistic way of approaching life and everything in it, and teaching that to everyone else. You might find that your father or father figure was someone who was optimistic, and that's where you got it from, and you're teaching their teachings to everyone else. So yeah, with this placement, whether it's business, being in charge, a CEO, a leader, or even a motivational speaker, a lot of success and opportunity will come to you with this placement. But it is important for you to apply yourself. If you are still here with me, please drop me a green heart in the comment box below to let me know that you are still here. Love yourself as if your life depended on it, because it does. Take care of yourself, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.